My name is Aron Barbey. I'm a cognitive neuroscientist at the Beckman Institute, and we study the neural systems that shape higher cognitive functions. General intelligence refers to a broad set of mental abilities that includes attention, perception, memory, language, and thought. General intelligence, however, doesn't capture everything that we mean by intelligence. Specifically, it doesn't include social and emotional aspects of intellectual function. We're fundamentally social beings, and our understanding not only involves basic cognitive abilities, but also involves productively applying those abilities to social situations so that we can navigate the social world and so that we can understand others. To study the brain systems that support general and emotional intelligence, we studied a large sample of 152 Vietnam veterans that had focal penetrating head injuries. One of the reasons why studying Vietnam veterans was unique is that the nature of combat in Vietnam typically produced injuries that were focal. For example, they would have penetrating head injuries that were due to shrapnel or low-velocity rounds, and that produced brain injuries that were very specific. So rather than damaging multiple brain areas, it was typically the case that their injuries would impact a small subset or individual brain structures. They were a remarkable group to study, and the fact that we studied 152 individuals with brain injuries allowed us to very precisely map the degree to which damage to specific brain areas was related to impairment in specific aspects of general and emotional intelligence. In the first step, we measured the nature and scope of their brain injury by using CT scans. We then administered a comprehensive battery of neuropsychological tests.
What do you think goes in this question mark?
And what we found was that, behaviorally speaking, there are strong correlations between performance on tests of general intelligence and performance on tests of emotional intelligence. We found, for example, that verbal comprehension reliably predicted emotional intelligence. It was also true for other aspects of general intelligence, including working memory, processing speed, and perceptual organization. At the level of the brain, we also found that there were strong dependencies, so that if the correlations in terms of behavior were high, so also were the correlations in terms of their overlap at the brain level. To a large extent, general intelligence and emotional intelligence share mechanisms, and people tend to use similar brain areas for both general and emotional intelligence. Our research applies to individuals with brain injury, but it also allows us to draw inferences about the broader population, that is, including individuals who don't have brain damage, because the results tell us that those areas are also necessary for performance, that, you know, healthy intellectual function principally depends on those brain systems. One of the reasons why we think emotional intelligence is important to study, specifically in the context of brain injury, is that one of the primary predictors of success and recovery following a brain injury is social support and the ability to function interpersonally. We think our research also opens the door to therapeutic interventions that might remediate impairments or deficits that individuals have in social and emotional functioning. Historically, general intelligence has thought to be separate from emotional intelligence, but our results suggest that general intelligence depends and also reflects, to a large extent, emotional intelligence. And so we think that understanding the architecture of the mind will really depend on not just advancing theories about general intelligence, but to broaden the scope of our investigation to incorporate essential aspects of social and emotional information processing.